Filipino Americans flocked to Virginia Beach to take part in the state's first ever Purple Yam or Ube Festival. Monica Galoso gives us a look.
Clothes, accessories, and many other items, but most of all, food. Everything is in color purple at the first ever Flavor of Ube Market event, held recently at the Operation Smile headquarters in Virginia Beach. The gathering was a chance for Filipino Americans and many others in the community to share their love of ube, or the purple yam, a huge staple in Philippine cuisine, especially when it comes to sweets. There were over 30 vendors selling all things ube, including desserts, ube-inspired shirts, artwork, and accessories.
We have different kinds of vendors. There's nonprofit, there's a lot of bakers, there's food trucks, there's a lot of ube, anything themed food, ube, we have it, ube everything.
The ube-themed event was also put together for a cause. It sought to help those in need of cleft surgeries in the Philippines through Operation Smile. Organizers say they want to create more awareness about the good work that the nonprofit organization has been doing.
They are a big part of helping people in the Philippines. So we thought it would be a good idea to hold the ube market in a place that benefits Filipinos in other ways.
Philip Odango is Operation Smile's Director of Events, Partnership and Community Engagement. He says the organization is both grateful and thrilled to celebrate the joy of eating, friendship, and family through Ube Market, especially in helping to create more smiles.
40 years ago, the Filipino-American community came together to sell lumpia, to sell food, to help raise money for Operation Smile patients with cleft lip and cleft palate. 40 years later, now in 2024, the same community, the next generation, has come together to do it again.
A silent auction during the event raised funds for 5 cleft surgeries in the Philippines. The Flavor of Ube Market was organized by Mabuhay 757, the same group that also organized the first ever Mabuhay Festival in Virginia Beach last year, which showcased different Filipino products, art, culture, and food. Monica Galazzo, ABS-CBN News, Virginia Beach, Virginia.
The Philippine Science and Energy Departments launched the first ever Filipino-made electric boat. The agencies held a technical demonstration of a prototype for the Safe, Efficient, and Sustainable Solar-Assisted Plug-in Electric Boat, or SESI. Powered by lithium-ion batteries, or ion batteries, can run for about 2 hours at speeds of nearly 16 kilometers per hour. Designed for local maritime needs like tourism, SESI can carry up to 12 people, or reconfigured for other purposes like diving or snorkeling. It can also be fitted with solar panels to extend operating hours. Researchers are now ready to work towards SESI's commercialization. Norway becomes a safe haven for Arctic foxes facing the threat of extinction as it maintains feeding stations across the alpine wilderness. But as this report tells us, such a move is not only rare, but also controversial.
In the wilds of southern Norway, endangered Arctic foxes are struggling to find enough food to eat. Climate change has made the foxes' rodent prey more scarce. That's why scientists breeding these endangered animals in captivity have also set up more than 30 feeding stations across the wilderness. It's a rare and controversial step in conservation circles. But without such feeding programs, some say the animals would go extinct.
If we stop the feeding now, we would see a decrease in the population sizes, and that would be really detrimental.
The Arctic fox has long been a symbol of the far north. Foxes were driven to near extinction across Scandinavia by hunters seeking their winter white fur. Hunting bans and protections introduced in the 1920s and 30s gave them some reprieve. But now they're facing a new invisible enemy. Arctic foxes need to hunt enough lemmings to make it through long winters. But scientists say warming temperatures have caused rodent populations to fall in recent years. Conservation biologist Christine Ulvand explains.
if we get warmer and more unstable climate where you get snow melt and you get icing on the ground, that is going to affect how well the rodents can survive.
So as part of the state-sponsored program to restore Arctic foxes, Norway has been feeding the population for nearly 20 years at an annual cost of roughly $300,000. The Norwegian Institute for Nature Research is managing the program.
In the mountain areas where we have released foxes, and also in stepping stone areas in between the release sites, we have feeding stations for the Arctic foxes. Those are made up of standing barrels with a laying barrel where the foxes can go in. And then in the last standing barrel, we have standard dog pellets that we fill into it and that the foxes eat.
Since 2006, the program has helped to boost the fox population from as few as 40 to around 550 across Scandinavia. But feeding animals to ensure a population survives, known as supplementary feeding, can be contentious. It can propagate diseases among the population, as animals cluster around feeding stations where pathogens can spread. Some scientists also question whether it makes sense to support animals in landscapes that can no longer sustain them. But others say feeding programs are necessary to prevent extinctions.
I think we've come a long way in saving this species. We've already seen that the population is rising. We're getting larger subpopulations, and we're getting more exchange of individuals between populations. But I still think we have some way to go before we can say that we've really saved the species.
Thailand banning the recreational use of marijuana by year-end, but will continue to allow its use for medical purposes. The health ministry says the misuse of cannabis has a negative impact on Thai children and lead to other drugs in the long run. Thailand became the first country in Southeast Asia to free up medicinal use in 2018, then recreational use in 2022. But the previous government failed to push legislation before last year's election, leaving Thailand without an umbrella law for cannabis regulation. Thousands of cannabis shops have sprung up in Thailand in an industry that is projected to be worth up to $1.2 billion by next year. U.S. lawmakers avert a shutdown with the passage of a stopgap funding bill. The Democratic majority Senate late Thursday, after the Republican-controlled House backed it with less than 36 hours before funding would have begun to run out. Now the bill next goes to President Joe Biden's desk for signing into law. The measure sets deadlines to fund one part of government until March 8 and another portion until March 22. Even with the passage of the temporary funding bill, Congress still faces potential battles during the next few weeks over funding levels for many programs that conservatives want to pare back. House Speaker Mike Johnson is under pressure by hardline Republicans to use a shutdown as a bargaining chip to force Democrats to accept conservative policy measures. The United States not seeing any sign Russia is preparing to use a nuclear weapon. See on Thursday, Russian President Vladimir Putin warned NATO countries they risk provoking a nuclear war if the alliance sends troops to Ukraine. French President Emmanuel Macron had floated the idea, which was quickly ruled out by the U.S. and key European allies. Addressing Putin's threat, the U.S. State Department says this is not the first time they have seen irresponsible rhetoric from the Russian leader.
It is no way for the leader of a nuclear-armed state to speak. We have communicated in the past privately and directly with Russia about the consequences of the use of a nuclear weapon. That said, we do not have any sign that Russia is preparing to use a nuclear weapon, and we will continue to monitor this carefully.
At least 43 people are killed after a fire broke out at a seven-story building in the Bangladeshi capital of Dhaka. The fire originated at a popular restaurant, which quickly spread to the upper floors, trapping scores of people. Firefighters used a crane to carry out the rescue. At least 40 others are injured and are being treated in the city's main burn hospital. Authorities have yet to establish the cause of the blaze. Widespread flooding in Bolivia following days of heavy rain. At least 42 have died and 31,000 others displaced. Now damage has been heaviest in the northern city of Cobija, which lies across the border from Brazil. The city's mayor has declared the area a disaster zone. In one rural area, local authorities had to dig through mud to allow aid to come through. The administrative capital of La Paz has been put on red alert. ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel, is offering viewers access to our full lineup of shows on YouTube through the ANC Prestige subscription program. Now, ANC Prestige subscribers in the Philippines can watch all of our shows, including news programs and features, all for just 99 pesos a month. Pricing may vary in other territories, but that's not all. Subscribers can also get exclusive access to on-demand news, business and lifestyle content, and even exclusive photos and videos. So head on over to ANC's official YouTube channel and join ANC Prestige.